Time is an odd thing. I left Karnaca decades ago, excited about all the Dunwall might hold. I remember falling in love with Jessamine, watching her crowned as Empress, Emily's birth, the rat plague, then Jessamine's death and another coronation. Now all this, back in the city where I was born. Stilton's home hides a mystery, but I'll tear it apart brick by brick to learn the secret of Delilah's immortality, as long as it ends with her in chains. She might have pulled herself up from nothing, but I ran out of sympathy for tyrants and witches a long time ago. All I want is to put an end to Delilah's reign and make sure Emily is safe. One more time. Definitely odd. Something just shifted. Stilton's sealed off from the rest of the district. This place is cursed, cracked. I can feel the void seeping in. Food for Stilton.
They drop food for me, in and out, like the wind. I think they're afraid. We'll be getting started soon. The Duke's beloved is coming back. I dreamed the Duke and I were hunting, but the deer had faces. There are whales down in the mines. I hear them howling to one another. Swollen beasts. How did I get so old? Where are the men of my younger days? The dances we had here. Time is leaking, coming out of the walls. It's ruining the carpets. Go to Dunwall and tell the Empress that the Duke is in the garden digging up corpses, and he has learned how to sing. She'll know what you mean. That thing of bones that Ashworth made. It's on the ceiling. I hear it at night. Bones from the deep, far beneath the waves. I think I heard something under my shirt. What's that? Nothing. What time is it? Is it the time I think it is? Someday I'll play the piano for you, Theodanus. That sound is funny. It's so bright in here when I close my eyes. Did I say something?
Stilton's manor is falling apart.
now.
Snap out of it, man.
Warm the quilts, will you?
I feel...
3 years ago, something inside Aramis Stilton snapped like a cheap lock. A part of him and a part of this house never left that evening. The Dukes and their circle are still gathered here, setting their grand plan into motion. Delilah's plan. And a part of Aramis Stilton is always here, still breaking. The Void is not exactly a place, and it's much older and stranger than you could ever know. It watches you from within, and at the heart of Stilton's house, the Void is leaking through a pinprick left behind by Delilah's little trick. Even magic is perverted here, and things don't work like they should. Take this. Imagine it's a kind of timepiece. Go and watch the Duke and Delilah. See for yourself what they did.
Like it's going to be cold tonight. Is there bad news from the mines? I can sense it. How many dead? This can't be right. Who has been fooling with the clocks? I'll have their pay docked. The days are burning. Can't you smell it? Right up in smoke. I remember that night, sitting out waiting. I knew it was wrong. I don't want you meddling with my things. My house is fine, you see? Theo? Where are you, my friend? I must speak to you. Let's have tea in the kitchen. I've got to clean up. They'll all see I don't belong among the upper crust, the fine people. I can't stand the way they look at me. Ashworth, Jindosh, and little Luca, grown up. They will never accept me. Not really. She clawed her way back! Ashworth helped open the way! Quiet! The one in the Void hears everything. Put that thing away, will you? Grotesque. Yes, yes, I can see it. The others can't, can they?
He is trapped inside himself. Some terrible ceremony echoes through his thoughts. There was a whisper and a groan. Strange as the wails in the deep. He hears it still. He would pluck out his own eyes if it would help him forget what he saw. Before this, he was so worried the old money people would laugh at him. They did. And he's singing. Wait. Not singing. Some vibration coming from the center of this place. Stilton looked deeply into the Void. He cannot unsee what he has seen. He was a doubter. He was afraid. That's why his mind was ruined on that night. The night this terrible thing happened to him. He wanted to meet with Megan. To confide in her. whose eyes see the teetering past and the ruined present. And the moments in between. Had he not been with the Duke on that night, his life would have been very different. Once Aaron Stilton knew his name, he worked to improve conditions at the mines. And now this, something about the Duke and a lake at night. But he recalls the father, not the son. I am tired. How long, my dears? How long must I endure in this shadow state?
By the Void.
The Duke is demanding refreshments, and I can't get in without the combination.
There's a note on the door, Captain Windelbaum.
What? He's out back. I need the code to the study.
It's in his notebook, ma'am. But he keeps it with him.
Thank you, Corporal. Speaking bluntly, I really don't like Stilton's guests. Earlier, I got my ass chewed out by the Royal Curator. What's her name?
You're talking about Brianna Ashworth, I believe.
Yes, that's her. She's an odd one. Anyway, keep up the good work.
Thank you, Captain.
I can still hear the tick-tock of the metronome I used when teaching Emily to fence. I remember Jessamine learning to play and trying to get Emily to practice. The only way out of here is through the present, using this timepiece. Stilton had taste before lunacy took his mind. will change in the present based on what I do here tonight.
Did I close my locker before coming out? Ugh. Last time I left it open, someone left a hagfish in my jacket pocket. Here's something else you should know. The center of manor is off limits tonight. Everything around the study.
What's so special about the center of the manor?
Nothing, usually. But the Duke and his party are here tonight, and they don't want to be disturbed. So that entire part of the house is under lockdown by the Grand Guard.
I'm not sure how to take your tone. I assure you, I rub shoulders with some of Karnaka's best people.
Trust me, you don't want to get tangled up with the Duke and his inner circle. I'm not sure how Mr. Stilton tolerates them, to be honest.
Tossed off at the last minute because he's got more important guests? That's not like Stilton. At least it's the likes of Jindosh and Ashworth, and dare I say it, the Duke himself. I might have gotten shuffled aside, but I'll have a story to tell. Never know such an elegant manor could be buried at the heart of an industrial district.
Stilton wasn't born to all this. Allegedly, he started as a miner. Megan claims Stilton was a good man, at odds with the Duke.
Tonight, Duke of Bell and the others will drink my expensive whiskey and scheme. Jindosh will watch me like a cat with a half-chewed mouse. Ashworth will sneer about how conventional the rest of us are. Missing the obvious, she'll flirt for a while, then put me in my place. I'll sit on my anger, remembering what Theodanus meant to me. I'll tell myself I worked for this honor. I swung a pick in the mines, and now the fine folk are guests in my house. If they want to hold a seance, who am I to say it's nonsense? Whatever happens, I'll regret it. But afterward, Megan's coming by. Talking with her always sets me right.
I can't do anything.
You have to understand. I'm going to call for help.
Can actually play the harp or the piano?
Not that I ever heard.
What am I doing here then? Why hire a tuner for instruments no one ever plays?
If you ask me, Stilton thinks a harp or a piano is the kind of thing a man in his position should own.
I'm not sure what that means. I've always thought people bought an instrument because they liked music.
Not always. Sometimes it's about appearances. Once they say something's amiss, then I just can't get comfortable.
Understand. I'm going to call for help if you don't go.
I pay good money to make sure
whatever you need, I can't help you.
Might be able to get around that, going back into the past. Thank you. wonder what I was doing in Dunwall on this night. Or what I am doing.
Jawed hagfish. River crust is more likely. Can I read? Of course I can read. What's he think?